I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on the wiring for both power and communications to the 550A case control.
Thanks, Keith. This case controller can control superheat, temperature, lights, fans, defrost, and anti-sweats for a single evaporator. On this case controller, we have several inputs, and then we'll cover the outputs. Up here at the top, we have digital inputs, numbers 1 and 2, for things like door switches, dual temp switches, cleaning switches, and so on. Moving down the line, we have a pressure transducer here, which would be the Danfoss AK-CC 32R pressure transducer used to measure the outlet pressure on the coil. This helps us measure the superheat. Going down the line, we have the S2 sensor, which is the coil out temp sensor. The next sensor is an optional one. It's the S3 sensor, which is a return air sensor. This is needed if you want to do adaptive defrost. The S4 sensor is our discharge air temperature. The next sensor is optional. It's the S5 defrost termination sensor. And lastly, we have the S6 product sensor, which of course is optional. Going on down the line, we have communication inputs. We have options on this controller for actually two options. There's the LAN RS-485 and the built-in Modbus RS-485 communication option that'll allow communication back to your system manager. The Modbus option is built in, like we said. If you want to use the LAN RS-485, then we need to install the communication card. That communication card allows communication back to the system manager, and we're going to show how to install that now. First, we disconnect power to the controller. Then, we remove this little plastic cover in the front, and we'll insert our communication card with it right side up. And then we'll reinsert our cover. And then we'll power up the controller again. The communication wire for either one of these options is the EIA 485 wire, and the specification is shown on your screen. For the button usage on this controller, we have three buttons on this side. The top button will give us status codes on the controller. These status codes, such as this one, could be telling us what the controller is currently doing. If we press it again, we would get an alarm code if one exists in the controller. But if there is an alarm in the controller, you'll see these icons on the side will be flashing. If we press this top button longer, we can enter the parameter list. The parameter list will give us all the programming options for the controller, starting with R01. If we don't press any buttons for 15 seconds, the controller will time out and go back to the temperature display. The middle button will be used for changing the cutout temperature of the evaporator. This shows us what the temperature setting is now, and we can use the top or the bottom button to change that. The top button will increase the temperature setting, and the bottom button will decrease the temperature setting. When we're finished making our change, then we could just press the middle button to save it. The bottom button is used for scrolling through parameters, and it's used when we're not in the parameter listing. We can use it to look up the defrost termination temperature, and if there's no temperature sensor assigned, it'll just read NON, indicating that there is none, no defrost termination sensor set up in this controller. The parameters, as we said, can be accessed by holding the top button down until you get through the status codes and the alarm code. Now that we're in the parameter list, we can go down through the parameters. If we want to make a change, we can always use the middle button for that. And then if we want to save it, we hit the middle button again. And as we said, the controller will time out after 15 seconds. Across the bottom of the controller, we have the relay connections. First, we have the AKV relay. This solid-state relay is used to cycle the AKV valve for pulsing liquid into the coil. Then we have the evaporator fans, defrost, lights, and anti-sweats. The only connection here that's done normally closed, typically, would be the fan relay. Of course, the rest would be normally open. Since these relays are not fused internally, all fusing would be done external to the controller. And the relays that are inside this controller have their current limitations, so typically pilot relays are used to control the loads. And they're wired between this controller and the load itself to meet the demands of inrush current and running load amps, etc. And that's the AK-CC 550A case controller.
For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.